Okay, what we're going to take a look at today is our missing number equations. Okay, we've seen these on our Standards Mastery, we've seen on worksheets. I'm going to go through how to kind of attack these and how we are able to figure these out. Okay? So first we're going to take a look at when we have our dividend and our divisor. All we're looking for is the answer. All you do is divide. Divide using our process that we've been doing. Okay, divide our dividend by our divisor. So I just take my 49, divide by my 3.5. Now remember, that's got a decimal in my divisor. I've got to make it a whole number, so I've got to move that there. Remember, that's multiplying by 10 to the first power. This one I have to multiply by 10 to the first power as well. Remember, our invisible decimal is here. So really, I'm taking 490 divided by 35. Okay? 4 can't be divided by 35. 35 goes into 49 one time. Subtract. 9 minus 5 is 4. 4 minus 3 is 1. Bring down my 0. Okay, now I'm going to see how many times does 35 go into 140. Remember, we kind of estimate. This is about 40. This is 140. 4 times 3 usually gets us 12. 4 times 4 would be too much. But maybe for 35, because this is a little over, let's try it. So I'm going to take 35 times 4. 4 times 3 is 12, plus 2 is 140. Okay, so there you go. 4 times 35, 140. And there's my answer, 14. Okay, so let's go through some practice ones here. Okay, so 41.6 divided by 2.6. Again, don't overthink them. Just because it has a space for where our answer is, don't overthink it. You have a dividend, divisor, go ahead and divide. Now remember, I've got a decimal here, so I'm going to move these over one. So I've got 416, 16 divided by 26. Okay, how many times does 26 go to 41? Only one time, because I know 26 times 2 is 42, so that's only one. Subtract. Careful of your subtraction. 11 minus 6 is 5. 3 minus 2 is 1. Bring down a 6. Okay? Now, 2, this is about 25, about 20. We go to 30. 30 times what gets me close to 150? Maybe 5. So I'm going to try it times 5. 5 times 6 is 30. Carry my 3. 5 times 2 is 10 plus 3. Okay, so I think that's going to be a little bit short. It's a little bit, so I got to try my 6. Okay, so that didn't work, so let's try my 6. 26 times 6. 6 times 6 is 36. 6 times 2 is 12 plus 3 is 156. Okay, so 6 times 6 is 156. Subtract, and we've got 16. Okay? I want you to try this one on your own. Pause it, work out the problem, and then we'll go over it together. Okay, so let's take a look at this. Again, dividing by our decimals, I'm going to make this a whole number. So I multiply by 10 to move that over. Multiply by 10 to move that over. So I get 663 divided by 39. 139 goes into 66. So I subtract. 16 minus 9 is 7. 5 minus 3 is 2. Bring down my 3. Okay. 270, 40 goes into 270. 4 times 7 gives us 28. So I'm going to try 6. I'm going to try 6. So 39 times 6. 6 times 9 is 54. 6 times 3 is 18 plus 234. Oh, so I'm still short. So now I'm going to try. That one doesn't work. I'm going to try the 7. 9 times 7 is 63. 7 times 3 is 21 plus 7, or 6 is 27. Okay, so we'll get, then this is the number I'm using, times 7. 7 times 39, we worked it over there, is 273. So my answer is 17. Okay? Good. Now what happens if I have my divisor and my quotient? My divisor and my quotient. What we're going to do now here is we are going to multiply. Now let's multiply my quotient by my divisor, okay, to get my dividend. So I'm going to take 30 times 2.6, okay, 6 times 0, 6 times 3 is 18, put in my 0, 2 times 0, 2 times 3, add those, okay, put in my decimal, one decimal place, and my answer becomes 78. Okay? Sometimes you divide them, sometimes you multiply them. It depends on which way you're going here. Alright? So let's do another example. Missing the first number, I'm going to multiply these two. Multiply these two. So I'm going to take 20 times 38. 8 times 0, 8 times 2. Let me write that better for you. Well, 8 times 0 is 0. There we go. Put in my placeholder. 3 times 0 is 0. 3 times 2 is 6. 0, 6, 7. I've got one decimal place. So I can put one decimal place back in my answer. So I get 76. Could I put 76.0? Yep, I could. Same thing. Okay, pause. Do that one as a practice, and we'll go over it. Okay, so let's take a look at this one. I'm missing my dividend. I'm missing my first number. I'm going to take and multiply these. It's kind of like the reverse, doing the reverse operation. Okay, reverse equation, I said. 25 times this is going to equal this. Let me rewrite that for you. So what I'm doing is 25 times 2.4 equals this. Doing that reverse equation that we've been seeing. Okay? So 25 times 2.4. 4 times 5 is 20. Carry my 2. 4 times 2 is 8 plus 2 is 10. Okay, put in my placeholder. 2, I'm done with this one. 2 times 5 is 10. 2 times 2 is 4 plus 1 is 5. Put in one decimal. Sorry about that. So my answer becomes 60. Okay. Next one. Now we're missing this part. Now we're missing this part. Okay? So now this is one of those tricky ones where you would think, oh, I can just reverse it. I can take my 3.5 times my 0.49 equals this. No. Because this is a division, and this is our dividend. This is our dividend. Then we basically are switching our dividend, our divisor, and our quotient. Okay, so we're going to divide our quotient, I'm sorry, dividend by a quotient. My fault. Now I'm going to take this and divide it by this. So I'm kind of switching these two. So I'm taking the 4.9 divided by 3.5 to give my answer. Sometimes if you're not sure what to do, it's easy. Sometimes if we switch the, we can just put in the whole numbers. Okay? It doesn't mean that's what I'm looking for my answer, but it helps me see what, how I'm going to do my steps. Okay? So if I would put in 8 divided by something equals 2, how would I kind of approach that? I can't take 2 times 8 to get this because that would not be correct. Okay, so what I have to think about is, remember those with our problems, I can take my 8 divided by 2 to get this answer. So my divisor and my quotient can switch. Okay? So I know 8 divided by 4 is 2. So to get the same answer down here, I have to take my 8 divided by 2 to get my 4. Okay? So let's practice those. Okay? So I've got my 0.45 divided by something that equals 2.5. Again, I'm just going to switch these two. So I'm going to do 0.45 divided by 2.5. Okay? Now, I see my divisor. I have a decimal. I don't want the decimal, so I have to move my decimal place here. Move my decimal place here, so I get 4.5. Oops, sorry. Let me check this one a second. We may not be able to do these as our practice ones. I'm going to have to adjust these problems. Okay. I apologize. Okay. I want this to be 0.50, and I need this one to be 0.90. Okay, we're still going to do the same thing, where we take and go 0.50 divided by 2.5. Okay? We're still going to move our decimal one place, because this one only has one decimal place, so then I get 5.0 divided by 25. Okay, now from here, I'm going to divide. How many times does 25 go into 50? 2 times. Put in my decimal, so my answer becomes 0.2. Sorry, I didn't see that from before, okay? Okay. All right, so again, we take a look at this. I'm going to switch my quotient and my divisor. So I'm going to do 0.90 divided by 4.5. I see that I have a decimal here, so I need to move it one place. So I get 9.0